Ratchet and Clank, a cracking time. So I spent about 3 attempts trying to do the final challenge of the Battleplex, but I failed all of them. I got to about wave 15, then just got swarmed. And for some reason, there seems to be some really weird, like, inconsistency with how the boxes like ammo and health get spawned, because the first one, all it spawned was health boxes, didn't give me any ammo. Second time, all it gave me was ammo and didn't give me any health. And I'm always like, I'm really close to leveling up, so I was begging the third time for it to just level me up already, but it wouldn't. So I decided I'm gonna return to that later, probably when I level up, and for now we're gonna go get all the extra collectibles on the planets that I missed. I only have about 10 zony left. Oh wow, my next upgrade isn't until 35. And there's not any zony on this planet, there's just 3 golden bolts. Now, in the Battleplex, one of the rewards that I got was a treasure marker, so that's good. That'll tell me where all the golden bolts are and will really reduce the amount of time I have to spend looking for them. So I'm pretty sure I know where one is on here, but I don't really know where the others are, so let's take a look at the map. Okay, there's one. There's my ship, right? Where am I? I still have no idea how to read this thing. Okay, let's see here. Okay, yeah, okay, that's my ship. So there's one kind of to the right here. I think this one I did miss. Yes, okay. I remember the first time I played this, this one was the first one I got, and I was wondering why I didn't pick it up when I played this playthrough, but I guess I just totally missed it. So to be warned, or to warn you, this might be another half an hour long video, although the last few videos have been pretty dang long, so just expect that at this point. And if you don't like that, if you wanna just wait, then you can, of course, skip the video. Anyway. Let's see, what is here? It said there's... Oh, it's over there. Is that... I'm assuming this is just a teleporter. I just want to make sure. Yeah, okay. That's just a teleporter. Alrighty, so where does that take me? That takes me in there, and the golden bolt's right by there. So it seems that that's all that's here. Okay, no rhino holoplans. Alright, so let's head on over there to get to the other golden bolt. Do you want to move there, Ratchet, or do you just want to sit in place? Man, that stupid final challenge in that Battleplex. Like, it wouldn't even be difficult once I get to the main bosses, like the Hydra and all that. That won't even be hard. Like, seriously, that really will not be hard at all. But what's hard is getting to that. I mean, look how close I am to leveling up. I could get my health to show again. I guess I won't. Okay. Anyway, there's the other golden bolt. How the heck did I get up there before? I think there was a place up here where I could boost onto it. So I remember Cork walking through here, and I remember seeing that arrow that had like a hover boost on it. I don't know where it is though. Okay, this wouldn't be it, I don't think. Unless I just kind of jump on here, does it let me? No, it's not gonna let me jump on there. So then, how do I get up there, Mr. Game? How do I get up there? Oh wait, I think it's over there. Okay. Yeah, that's where it is. Alrighty. So, I don't know how long it's gonna take me to collect all of these. I kinda wanna do every planet in one video, but I'll probably split it up again and, you know, have however many it takes. Here we go. Okay, so the last one, trying to figure out if it's easier just for me to go back and teleport, or if I... It looks like it'll be quicker if I just go back and teleport to grab it. I get my boots on. So back to the ship, and then over here kind of to the left, and into the goat world. Okay, so this is where all the destruction was, and it looks like, man, I still cannot keep track of where I am. That's because my arrow, for whatever reason, is hidden behind the teleporter. Okay. So I guess we'll go down here. Hey, goat guys. And it'll be up there.
How are you?
I would be a lot better if you guys weren't so useless. Okay, so it's to the right. It's probably right down there. Yep, there it is. Okay, so I believe that is everything on this planet. I kind of wish it would tell me, but I think on the outside it said all I needed were the golden bolts, so I believe that's it. I don't know if these planets get grayed out when you collect everything. I just hope I'm not missing the holo plans. Where's the teleporter? It's up there. Okay.
Can I have your autograph?
No. Okay, I have no idea how to get to the teleporter. Can I leave the planet somehow? Probably not. Nope. Oh, dang it. Okay, what's the quickest way to get to that teleporter, do we think? I jumped off of the ding ledge. It's that way, right? Yeah, it's right there. It's kind of over here, I guess. You know, you guys could be repairing this instead of, you know, playing the drums, but I guess that's okay. Okay, is the teleporter through here? I think so. That's just so annoying, that stupid Battleplex. I spent an hour doing the final challenge, and number one, like, I just would not level up for the life of me, and then it just would not give me health. And the thing that kept killing me was that they would send all these Agorians at you, and they would spawn on top of you, and they would just murder you. And then I'd get ammo, but then I'd get ammo for the wrong weapons. And my other weapons aren't high enough level to do too much damage. So that was a little bit annoying. And then I would try to boost through them, but then they have like... It's like you hit a square when you run into some of the enemies. You just hit a box. So if you try to go under their arm, you come to a dead stop anyway. So it's like a pain because then they try to... I don't know, it was really annoying. But anyway, I'm going to fly closer to this planet. Yep, I got everything there. Okay, so... Let's go and come back here. Completed, good. So, Phylax sector is completed. Oh, now it tells me how many golden bolts and other things there are. Alright, come here to Vila sector. Oh, what? Oh, the treasure thing must do that. Okay, so are those Rhino card plans? I think there are. There's two there, two more there, and two there. Jeez. But still, zoning more bolts. Okay. So, back to one of the other two planets here.
Now entering Vila Sector.
Alright, let's go to the planet behind me, just cause. This one's kinda cool looking. Is this the big city? I think it might be. Let's see what's waiting here for us. Oh, this is that comet place. Okay, and through we go. There we are. So we're missing a holo plan, two gold bolts, and two zoni. Okay. So many loading screens. I think the last 2 minutes have been waiting. Oh, I don't know how many planets I want to do for this collectibles video. I'll just decide as the time goes on. I need to think of other topics to talk about. I've exhausted a lot of them. A friend started playing Oblivion again, and he says it's just as good as he remembers, except for the graphics, which I said, well, yeah, you kind of need to get the, you know, unofficial mods for that, unofficial patches. It looks like there's Sony there. Alright, let's first take a look at where I am, because again, it's kind of confusing. We need to get to the right side, and there's a golden bolt over there. So if I can get back there, let's see where the teleporter takes me. What the crap? Oh no. And there's a golden bolt at the end of this. Alright, well, let's get this golden bolt first. No, not that. Let's use my rocket. So did I not kill you, or do you enemies just respawn? I'm not really sure. I guess you guys just respawn. That's okay. So I need to go all the way down and to the left. Okay. Thank you, Clank. I'm so happy I can do that again. Although I feel like that was a little bit faster in the last games. Oh dear. Okay. And what's left? Is this already 5? Yeah, okay. These are not. Oh, those are. You are not 5. So I'm wondering how I missed this gold bolt, because that's like painfully right there in front of me. Ouch! Must have had to have like run through this and just not looked at it. I don't have any idea. Alright, we'll head back. So there's one of them. Just, we'll check the map again to make sure there's nothing else here. No, there is not. And then I think I'll just boost my way through. The enemies should be dead. Hopefully they don't respawn on the way back. Okay, that kind of, that made me jump a little bit. I was like, where the heck did that zombie come from? And, or not zombie, that robot. And he also kind of sounded like a synth. And that means I gotta play the new Fallout DLC, which is gonna be awesome. Although I gotta say, Fallout 4, speaking of topics, Fallout 4 really is like kind of hit and miss, depending on whether or not people like it. Which is kind of sad, because I thought it was a really good game. I love Fallout 4. But I can kind of see where some people are coming from, I guess. I mean, my only issue is they played the crap out of Fallout New Vegas, and that's where most of the comparisons come in, is Fallout New Vegas this, Fallout New Vegas that. But New Vegas wasn't made by Bethesda, it was made by Obsidian. So I guess you could say Obsidian can make a better Fallout game than Bethesda, which you could have as a valid argument, but I don't think I could really say Fallout isn't a Bethesda game, because it feels pretty Bethesda to me. And then people say that it's not a Fallout game, but I kind of have to question where they come up with that statement, because Fallout 1 and 2 were the originals. They were like these isometric, kind of Baldur's Gate sort of style, maybe closer to XCOM than really anything else. But, you know, they were these really dang different games. A whole lot of people hadn't really, well, wait, not at the time when they came out, they weren't too different, but anyway, and then Fallout 3 comes out vastly, vastly, vastly different from Fallout 2, and surprised a lot of people, because not a whole lot of people honestly had heard of Fallout until Fallout 3 came out. I mean, they just hadn't. Great, how the heck do I get back over there?
Why do you hide, sticky aliens, Mr. Zircon?
So then New Vegas comes out, which is a lot like 3, but with a heck of a lot more story options and choice options. Wow, Clank, what the hell, Ratchet, what are you doing? So in a way, New Vegas was even more different than 3 was from 2, and like, not really too different, but in its own kind of way. Which means that Fallout 4 is way different from any of them. So that makes me question, where do people come up with this whole thing that it's not a Fallout game? Because at this point, I don't know what is a Fallout game. They're all so dang different. Like, every single one of them is weirder than the other. So I don't know what makes a Fallout game, so I don't really know if I can say Fallout 4 isn't a Fallout game, because it's post-nuclear. Oh, now I get my level up. Gee, thanks. I mean, it's post-nuclear war. It's dark, gory, fun, has more jump scares than Amnesia. I mean, that's all I ask for in a Fallout game. That's what I got in Fallout 4. Oh, I could have just taken this. Could I? Maybe. And I know some people wanted it to not be so dumbed down, and I do kind of agree with that. That just seems to be a trend with Bethesda, though, because Oblivion's a dumbed-down version of Morrowind, and Skyrim's a dumbed-down version of Oblivion. And I was kind of surprised that they dumbed down Skyrim as much as they did, because they did things like removed, repair... Hey, come back here. What are you doing? They removed repair hammers, which were an extremely annoying thing in Oblivion. They really truly were, but they were fun because it meant you had to worry about one more thing. And in Skyrim, you didn't have to worry about any of your stuff degrading because they just, I don't know, you just didn't have to worry about it. Come here, Zoni. Come here. Thank you. And then they just came out with Doom, and I guess that did okay. What is that? Looks like there's a Rhino card. I guess people like Doom. I don't want to pay $60 for it, but I am pretty interested in trying it. I don't have any money right now anyway. And the thing is, like, this is an image that kind of went floating around, and it had the IGN reviews, and it had a review of Call of Duty Ghosts, and they called it Next Gen, Innovative, Good, lots of fun, and then they had Doom, and it's like Doom feels like imitation, kind of undone or kind of overdone, you know, sort of boring, and it's like, well, the point of Doom was to be an imitation. The point of, that was the whole point of it, was to imitate the original, and then Ghosts, their next gen, their definition of next gen is better fish. But, you know, what are you gonna do? Okay. Okay, I have no idea how I'm supposed to get over there now. Let's go this way. Is it this way? That's not a way. Maybe if I ride the transport. Let's see where the transport takes us. Hello, Jetty Dog. You always get annoyed. My dog always gets annoyed when I don't pet her, but she's always like an inch out of reach of being able to pet her. And then she just walks away. I don't get it. Alright, the transport just takes me all the way back to the beginning. Dang it, I was hoping it wouldn't. Well, the other question is, how do I get over there? This planet's a little bit confusing. I need to get to that other side somehow. Oh, maybe that way. Is that a big gaping hole that I missed? Oh, there it is. Okay. Oh, wait, no. That's glass. It's a big thing of glass. How do I get over there? Oh, wait, this thing? Oh, okay. Here we go. That's right. I remember. Unless it takes me to the wrong spot. Nope, right spot. Okay, so Sony's on the complete other end here. Or he should be, anyway. Let's pull out the negotiator. Ah, oh, jeez, I think even with that health upgrade, I don't think I could finish off that final place. I think what I really need is a few more upgraded weapons and, like, that battleplex. I mean, I need a few more upgraded weapons and, more importantly, the next armor upgrade, which should be coming soon. I imagine it'll be after the nefarious place, but we'll see about that. Okay, I need a battery bot for you, don't I? Where the heck do I get one of those? Probably not that way. It's probably up there, so can I climb up this? I remember seeing him, and I remember thinking that I would find a battery bot at some point, so. It's gotta be soon, right? It's gotta be nearby. Because that looks like a battery place. Unless I can just throw my wrench in there again. How did I do that? Oh! There's a glitch. Come on, glitch. Work in my favor. Oh, no. That's not fair. Come on. Come on. okay, what do I do? I need the battery bot. I don't know where the battery bot is. Unless he's this way. These battery bots are really annoying. So let's go check over here. I guess I should do this. Unless there's like one of these transport holes in there, so I don't know if I can activate one of those somehow. That one? No. That one? No. So I think the other way is how I'm going to get over there to that golden bolt, but I really want that zony, so... How do I free you, zony? How do I free you? I can't climb up here. Oh, I got double jump with Clank now, okay. Maybe I can. Oh, grab on! No. Can I even get up there? All the stuff they don't explain that when you have Clank, because he can do a lot more now. But I don't think it matters. I can't really do anything. Might have to look this zony up, because I'm just going to be wandering around for like an hour. Oh! Darn it. Alright, I'm gonna look up how to free this zony. What planet am I on? Axiom City. Alright, so I guess there's another elusive battery bot in the previous area. I was wondering where he'd be. Of course, knowing that that one challenge that I did, where I had to spend a lot of time... Or, what am I trying to say here? Anyway, that one challenge... There you are, you idiot. The one challenge I did in the Battleplex, where you had to throw 8 of these battery bots into there. Holes, and I couldn't find one for my first attempt, because these things are stupidly annoying. Okay, so this zony took way too long. I'll probably cut that out. I'll have to remind myself to do that, though. Yay, so that's all 3 zony on this planet, and that means 1 more golden bolt, and I should be good. And I think I just gotta go this way. Whoa. You know, it makes me wonder, they don't throw nearly as many enemies at you as they, get a golden bolt's in here somewhere, it's just right up there. Can I ride this? Oh, there it is, okay. Anyway, they don't throw as many enemies at you as they do when you first come here, which makes me wonder why the heck they even throw any enemies at all, because it's like, not worth coming here to kill them to level up your weapons, because there's not enough. So, they're just kind of in the way, and there's not really enough for them to be challenging. So it just makes me wonder why have them at all? I have no idea. Oh, I wish I could open up my map and double check to make sure that I don't, that I'm not missing anything. Okay, so, let's see. Nope, nothing. Got it. Okay. And then, of course, I will double check when I leave, and then we'll head on over to the other planet. And we're nearing about 30 minutes, interestingly. I think I'll keep going, because I'm probably going to cut out some of that zony hunting. Okay, what else could I ramble about Bethesda? I mean, there's nothing wrong with Skyrim. I guess I should say that. There's nothing wrong with it, really. I love how the big thing with Oblivion was that every single cave looked exactly the same, and that didn't bother me as much as other people, because at the time I was also playing RuneScape a lot, and in RuneScape, if you can't do the same thing over and over, then, you know, you can't really play games, but, you can't play that game. Okay, do you want to tell me, did I get everything here? Oh, it says completed, okay. So I didn't really mind doing the same thing over and over in Oblivion with the tunnels, and I cared more about the quests anyway. I loved the quests in Oblivion, and I think for what Oblivion lacked in a lot of, like, graphical and design stuff, I made up for way more in the quests, and it's kind of the opposite for Skyrim, because Skyrim didn't have that many good quests. There's a few memorable ones, but not nearly as memorable ones as Oblivion. I mean, in Oblivion, you get the ghost that wanders, and it's like a fun quest. You have to go get the ring to save him. In Oblivion, you put on a ring, or this guy wants you to get a ring inside of a well, and the ring is too heavy, you can't swim out, and you can't take it off, so you die. Unless you're an Argonian, then, you know, you can, you know, breathe underwater. You get to go inside of a painting. You get a magic paintbrush in Oblivion, and you get to do a lot of really cool Dark Brotherhood stuff. I think the Dark Brotherhood twists were way better in Oblivion than they were in Skyrim. I don't remember the Mage's Guild in either of the Elder Scrolls games. The Thieves' Guild in both of them kind of sucked, but the Gray Fox was really cool. Way cooler than the eyes that you found in Skyrim anyway, because then you got that cowl that you could wear, and all your bounty would go into that cowl. Okay, there's a golden bolt right there. I missed that. Wow, I am blind. I mean, point is, there's just a million more memorable quests in Oblivion, and Skyrim had its fair share, sort of. I mean, the main quest was a lot of fun in Skyrim. I did like the main quest, and I really, really liked the expansions. Both of those were awesome, the Dragonborn and the other thing, the one with the vampires. Both of those were amazing, but still, those were DLC. I mean, Oblivion's DLC was dang freaking Shivering Isles. How do you compete with Shivering Isles? You get Sheogorath, who when you attack him, he... Is there anything up here? I don't think there's anything up here, but I'm going to come up here anyway. When you attack Sheogorath, he puts a spell on you, and then he spawns you, like, 400 feet high, and you fall to your death. I mean, the only cool thing to that was, like, one of the Azura things in Skyrim had you up above the world for a little while. I think it was it Boethia? Might have been Boethia. And that was about it, though. Alright, so I think what I'm staring at right next to the teleporter there is something, so let's go find that. Oh, this is where I had to fight all those dang... Dang, this place was really annoying. Yeah, this is where I had to fight everything. Okay. So, teleporter's probably the better option, actually, because it's closer. I didn't realize how far that was. So, anyway, my point is, I'm not trying to... Like I said, Skyrim's a great game, but then all of a sudden here I am bashing on it. But the thing is, Skyrim's, like, level designs and the world design and just everything about its design was just so cool. I mean, it looked awesome. It played awesome. It was a good game. It was, and I liked how different it was. I liked how it improved the combat drastically. That was probably the other bigger complaint, is people really didn't like the combat in Oblivion. And I can see why. I mean, it was a little bit lacking, but, you know, it was Oblivion. It was really the only game of its kind at that time that I can think of that did a really good job. Unless you count Two Worlds, but nobody who doesn't have some kind of mental disorder counts Two Worlds, because that game... And I remember when that game was out, and it was sitting there next to Oblivion on the shelves, and I'm just like, why the heck would you pick Two Worlds when Oblivion's right there? I mean, sure, Two Worlds is $20. So I feel really sorry for some kid who... Okay, where is this? It's like that way, right? Yeah. So it's like it's on top of him. but is it on top of him? I feel really sorry for someone who wanted Oblivion, and you know this happened to some poor kid. Like, he wanted Oblivion, but his parents go there and they see Oblivion's $60, and then Two Worlds is sitting there at $20, and the cover looks pretty much the same. I got stuck. There we go. Cover's almost the same. I guess I can't go over there. Like, oh, it's relatively the same game. We'll just get this one. And then he plays Two Worlds, and he's probably expecting it not to suck, and it sucks because it's so bad. And then they made a sequel to Two Worlds. I couldn't believe that. I mean, I remember in Two Worlds, you couldn't change really much of anything on your character, except they had like 10 different options for eye color, and you couldn't see your eyes because the resolution just wasn't high enough. You couldn't even see your eyes the whole dang game. So it's like, why the heck can I change my eye color? Okay, where is that? Do I have to talk to... Holy crap, where did you come from? Whoa, that scared me. Okay. Anyway, let's see if I can jump back over here. Nope. Should be able to, but there's some stupid arbitrary wall there. That drives me the most insane for games. I wish they would just kind of... Aw, really? I'm here. I wish they would hide the fact that they need a wall. I wish they wouldn't painfully, obviously have a wall. Like... Or, okay, they would have, like, an actual wall there. Not like... Gosh dang it. How did that move that quick? They would have an actual wall there, not an invisible wall. Are you kidding me? That's not gonna be quick enough. Nope. Okay, what the heck? That's just gonna launch me immediately, so... Okay, oh dear. Alright, what's in here? That's the rail. That's the rail system. That'll take me up there. Maybe I can get up there then. Let's wait for the flames. RPGs, though. RPGs are great. When they're good. Some of them try too hard. Okay, hope this takes me where I need to go. Let's see here. Alright, that takes me right there. And that's gonna launch me into here. Well, dang. Alright, so where the heck is that Rhino card? I feel like... Do I have to talk to any of you? I don't think so. Like, it's right in front of me. It's literally right in front of me, which leads me to believe it's up there. But I don't know how to get up there. Because I can't jump on anything. Okay, looks like I'll be looking up how to do this one too, although it's not there. Where is it? Alright, I think I'll be looking up this one too. Okay, so I found this finally. I think this is what'll lead me there, but I need oil. Where the heck am I gonna find oil now? So there's the next challenge. Where's the oil? Oh, there it is. Okay, so found it. That took a little while. I'll try to cut that rambling out. Or not the rambling. I'll try to cut out my random walking, though, because... Jeez, I wasted a lot of time. Okay, so that'll lead me right there. Good, good, good. Yeah, I will happily come see you, although I don't know where you are, so that'll be interesting. Okay, so I guess now we go backwards, because there's, what, only two bolts left? It looks like it, so hopefully those are the last two that I need. I think there's only one zone here. Alright, so let's go back, and we're almost at 40 dang minutes for this. Jeez, these collectibles are taking a little bit longer than I thought they would. I got all the collectibles for the Ratchet and Clank game on the PlayStation 4, the remake, and those ones did not take that long to get. Probably because I'd already done it before, but still. Wrong way. Dang it. Let's go the other way. Whoopsie. Jeez. These hover boots are not the most easily controlled things in the world. but I don't want to be a Vollard. That would be kind of that wouldn't be that fun, I don't think. Okay, so I just gotta keep walking this way. Ow! Whoa, that was close. I didn't think that would actually happen. Fire right, yep. Alrighty. Actually, let's pull out Mr. Frog. Okay, so Golden Bolt is in this next big area. Alright, where is it? Should be right in front of me. Is it down there somewhere? It's gotta be down here somewhere. Where is it? There it is. Okay. Now for the final Golden Bolt, which is probably somewhere on the railway. So let's see. Can I walk there? Can I, like, go over here? Do I have to... It looks like I have to get up there. Okay. So let's do that. Okay, how do I do that? This rail. No! Oh, dang it. Gosh dang it. Okay, maybe it'll work. Maybe I don't have to ride the rail. Okay, good. Let's see though. That's just gonna be kinda to the right. Let's get a good running boost here. Didn't work. What? Okay. Not gonna work. Alright, it looks like I have to come back around somewhere, so what the heck? Where am I? Okay. Cause I think it's over to my right. I think it's, yeah, it's hiding. Alright. So let's see if I can somehow get over in that direction. Check it out here really quick. Alright, good. So, where is it? That way. Yep. Directly in front of me somewhere. Oh, it's right in the middle of this fire pit. Okay, I'll take it. Okay, now the real question. How do I get back out? I guess I can go back this way. Let's see if I can boost onto there. Okay. And then I should be able to go backwards through the Vollard place, teleport back to the ship, and then return to the next planet. Oh, no, no, no. Dang it, you stupid, stupid game. Not what I wanted to do. Alright, I'll just jump back down there. A little bit surprised I made that jump, actually. Okay, which way is backwards? This way. Oh, you guys came back? Okay, fine. Whatever. Ow. You do not do 4 damage to me and live, idiot. Oh, this video is probably going to be one of the most boring ones. Okay, and they're back alive. Of course they are. Alright, just to double check, make sure there's no other collectibles here. Nope. Nope, nope, nope. Okay. Back to the teleporter, back to the ship, and then I guess returning here, just inside the ship. I'll just fly around to make sure I did actually complete the planet. I'm a little bit glad this one's finished. I do not like this world that much. Dang, and I think there's still 8 Zony left. Ugh. Alrighty. Completed and completed. Okay, so that is everything for that system. Now there's just this system. So I got everything there except for the final place. Wow, there's a lot of stuff left in Krell Canyon. I guess we'll go do the Tombly Outpost first. And after that, I'll probably end this video. And then we'll finish off the rest of the planets in the next one. And then maybe even beat the game today. I haven't decided yet. Although one of my friends might be bugging me and might be wanting me to get on and play other games too. So we'll see what happens today. But as I've said before, when I say that, it doesn't really matter when I stop playing, just because it's going to all get uploaded at the same time on YouTube anyway. Okay, so I think I want it to go behind me, right? I just want to make sure. I am missing 8 Zoni, right? So I'm missing 3 in this one, and then 2 in that one. So that only equals 5. Where the heck are the other 8 Zoni going to come from? Oh, I can just warp there? Oh, really? I don't have to... Dang it. I wish I had known that. I don't have to warp to the system? Wow, that was a waste of a few minutes then. Okay. Alrighty, back to the Tombly Outpost. This place was kind of fun, but let's see if it's any good. Alright, so I'm missing quite a lot of stuff here. Looks like a Constructo mod. There's a Rhino hologram there. I could have sworn there was like another, Okay, there's nothing there. I remember looking there when I came here. Anyway, I could have sworn there's like a golden bolt here, but it's not looking like there is. There's not even a teleporter. I don't know what that is right there. So, let's go get that Constructo mod and then go get the Rhino plan. Then I guess I'll leave the planet and see if this is the last. I thought there was another golden bolt here. I thought there were 3 collectibles I missed. I don't know where the third one is. Clank's boosting does not seem to boost as much as it used to. Okay. So, I need to go to the left. Unless I have to travel back in time. The third one might be back of that time portal, so I need to remember that. Okay, so you'll be this way, right? Okay, is this just the gear then? Not a Constructo mod. Oh, there it is. It's right there. Wow. Missed that one too. You know, I could have gotten all of these when I was playing this game. Okay, what does this modify? The shotgun again. They really like upgrading the shotgun. The lance. Let's try that one. And then detonator. Why not? Whoa, okay. Dang it, camera. You done screwed up again. Alright, I'm really all the way back here, holy crap. Alright, anyway, that might work out, but no it won't, that's gonna be annoying, jeez. Talk about first game checkpoints, and I'm gonna have to play Jak and Daxter soon. I'm gonna do Into the Nexus next. I'm not gonna 100% that game because I don't care enough. This one is so far my favorite Ratchet and Clank game, that's why I really wanted to 100% it. But Into the Nexus, I've never played, and I also learned that that game is part of the Future trilogy. Which means it's not a trilogy, because there's 4 games, unless you don't count, okay, I guess I can't go into the time portal. Unless you don't count Quest for Booty, because it's not really a full game, it's more like a half game. It's not even a half game, it's more like a quarter of a game. So I guess you could still call it a trilogy if you don't count Quest for Booty, but if you do, then it would be a quadology. Is that a word? I have no idea. Okay, let's take another look. I need to go somewhere. I want to see if I can see the hollow plan from here. Okay, that looks alive. Alright, I see it right up there. Okay, so I know where it is now. I just need to know how to get up there. I don't think there's any way here, so let's go on the other side. Oh, I would use hover boots, but they just take too long. Okay. Can I grab onto these? Nope. That's gonna send me back to the beginning, isn't it? Alright, I might just look this up too, because... But yeah, back at the beginning. Alright, Tombly Outpost Hollow Card. Whoops. No. Tombly, not Tumblr Outpost, you stupid autocorrect. I said Tombly. Dang it. Alrighty, let's see. Glide to the platform from the entrance to the building. Right. Having to go back to the beginning of the world, though, isn't really helping me much. Okay, so where the heck is the entrance to the building? Must be on the other side. So let's go up here. Maybe I can make it. Does this take me around? I really hope so. Ow, thank you. There's a box up there, even. I wonder how the heck you get to that. Okay. Alright. Oh, okay, I get it. I just had to come around to get here. See, what's annoying about this game is that all the shortcuts, like that right there, don't show up unless you've, unless you're here. I don't really know why that is. Okay, well, I think that's it for the collectibles here. I mean, that's to return back to the ship, and I see nothing else, but I could have sworn it said there were three left, so, I don't know, I guess we'll find out. We'll just head on back, kind of wish I could go the quick way. I mean, I thought maybe there might be another collectible inside of the time portal, but the time portal's closed up, so... That's not it. Whoa, stop doing that, camera. The camera in this game is not really perfect. It's good like 90% of the time, but it has a good 10% where it just gives up being a good camera. Alrighty, well, let's check it out then. And if that is the last one, then that'll be it for the video. Even if it isn't the last one, that'll still be it for this video. I'm gonna edit out a lot of stuff, but the running time right now is 5 minutes and or 50 minutes and 30 seconds. Not 5 minutes, 50 minutes and 30 seconds. So it's a dang long video, but you know, that's how collectibles go. Okay, let me open up the map. Come on, game. Come on, come on, come on. Thank you. Missing a golden bolt. Well, where the heck is it? Alright, well, I think I'm gonna find this golden bolt in the next video. That'll be it for this collectibles video. I'll continue on in part 41.